In the last lecture, we have seen how to design bandpass filter, how to design high pass filter and band stop filter with the help of low pass filter. Today we are going to discuss about how to convert the impulse response into a FIR system. How to convert infinite impulse response system into finite impulse response system with some approximations. For example, consider this one. This is H of n, which corresponds to impulse response of ideal low pass filter. We have seen that H of n equals to sin omega c n by pi n, where omega c is the cutoff frequency of the low pass filter, ideal low pass filter. This keeps on going. Oscillations are keeps on going. They are decreasing oscillations till infinity. This will go, and this will go till minus infinity. This will be non-zero till minus infinity. This will be non-zero till infinity. At least some finite value will be there. So we can call it like IIR system, infinite impulse response system. Just for the display purpose, we have shown from minus 50 to 50. This will go till minus infinity. This will go till plus infinity. What we are doing here is, we are trying to apply some windowing. This is a rectangle window. You can see this. This looks like a rectangle shape, right? Each one is having amplitude of 1 here, 1, and these are zeros. Minus 10 to plus 10, this is 1. And otherwise, this is equal to 0 in this particular example. This is a window. Now, we will try to multiply this window with this H of n. Multiply with H of n, what we are going to end up is 0 into something is 0, right? 0 into something is 0. All of these will become like zeros. This also will become like 0. This part also, except this part. 1 into this one is same as this particular part. This will be retained as it is, minus 10 to 10. You can see this, minus 10 to 10. This will be retained. And remaining everything got nullified, right? All these side things got nullified. Now, if you want to make it like a causal system means impulse response should be equal to 0 for n less than 0. If you want to do that one, you can try to delay this particular resultant H of n by an amount of 10 samples, right side. You can try to delay this, right? If you shift this right side by 10 samples, minus 10 will be shifted to 0. It will be shifted to 0, right? And 0 will be shifted to 10. 0 will be shifted to 10. Like that. 10 will be shifted to 20. Right shifted, right? And all these samples before them are zeros. You have seen this, right? Now, this is a final impulse response we are going to consider. In this case, we can see this particular impulse response is equal to 0 for n less than 0. So we can say this is a causal system. This is non-causal, this particular thing, because for n less than 0, this is non-zero. Same thing for this one. This is also non-causal system, right? Without this truncation or without this windowing operation, we can't convert this into a causal system. Because see, if you want to convert this into a causal system, you need to apply a delay of infinite samples, which is impossible, right? You can't provide a delay of infinite samples. Yeah, this is going till minus infinity. You want to shift minus infinity to zero location. You should try to delay that by infinite samples, then minus infinity will be shifted to zero, which is practically impossible, right? That's the reason you are going for truncation or windowing. Once you apply windowing, then you can shift by some finite delay, here delayed by just 10 samples to get a causal system. But the problem here is, this is just an approximation to this one. It's not exact one, right? Because we are nullifying this part. We are trying to nullify this part and this part from this. This is not an exact representation of this one. This is some approximation. But this is a very good approximation. The reason for this is, these are almost negligible, right? You go further and further, these components or these filter coefficients are almost negligible. This is also almost negligible if you go further. dominant part is in this region, right? Dominant filter coefficients are in this region. These are also contributing something, but little bit less compared to this part, this main lobe. You can say this is a better approximation of this one. We can't say exactly same as this. This is somewhat better approximation to this. Causal representation of this particular HFM with the help of windowing technique. Here we applied rectangular window in this example. Some cases we'll go for triangular window. Triangular window means we are going to get, for example, -10 to 10 like this, and 0 to 10 like this. Some triangle shape. Instead of all ones in this window, we are going to get like this. The reason for this triangular window is it will try to smooth this one. Instead of multiplying with all ones, we will try to multiply with the constant values in this triangle shape. This and this point by point multiplication. Remaining part is as it is. 0 and something is 0, 0 and something is 0, except this part. This part will be something different if you multiply point by point. Similarly, if you try to apply rectangular window of size, this is from -15 to +15. This is -15. See +15. This rectangular window from -15 to 15. This is 1, and these are zeros. If you try to multiply this point by point, then we are going to get as it is up to this part, -15 to 15, and remaining part will be nullified totally. And if you want to convert this into a causal system, you can simply apply a delay of 15 samples, right? Because before this one, everything is zero. No need to bother about them. We should try to make sure that it should be shifted at least beyond zero, right? If you try to shift this by 15 samples, then this will be shifted to zero. -15 will be shifted to zero. Zero will be shifted to 15 somewhere here, right? You can see this peak shifted to 15. And this particular 15 will be shifted to 30. Now you can see this is a causal system, right? Which can be practically implementable. This looks somewhat better as compared to this particular thing. You can see this is somewhat good approximation to this one as compared to this, right? As compared to this approximation. Because we are trying to consider 30 samples in this scenario. In this case, we are just considering only 20 samples, right? 21 samples here. Here we are considering 31 samples, including zero. This is somewhat better approximation compared to earlier one. These are some of the windows that we are going to follow, that we are going to apply to convert to FIR system. This is with a window length of 31. N from 0 to 31, N from 0 to 31. The center one should be 15, right? Including 0 means 31 samples are there. This is not actually continuous. These are the discrete samples. At 0 is a constant value. Let's consider this blue curve. Blue means Hamming window. At 0, this is the sample value. At 5 is the sample value. At 10 is the sample value. At discrete values of n, we are trying to get the constant samples. This is just for the representation purpose, this plot kind of thing. Actually, this should be discrete in nature. 0, 1, 2, 3, up to 30. Bartlett window, Hanning window, Hamming window, Blackman window. Rectangular window will be like this. We are going to have a rectangle window like this. This is a rectangle window. That should be equal to 1 within this window duration, right? 0 to 30. That should be always equal to 1, rectangular window means. At the end, you are having sharp transition, right? This sharp transition is there from 1 to 0. But for these windows, that's not sharp. The transition is not sharp. You can see this. Slowly decreasing to 0, right? And after that, this is 0. After this window, this will be 0. After this window, this will be 0. It is slowly decreasing to 0. There is no drastic change like rectangle. That's the difference here. Due to that drastic change from 1 to 0, for rectangle window, we are going to get more side lobes. Here, we are going to get less side lobes. For rectangular window, we are going to get more side lobes. We'll try to see that. a magnitude response of the equivalent analog low pass filter with rectangle window, Bartlett window, Hanning window, Hamming window, and Blackman window. You can see for the rectangle window, this pink color, there are ripples, right? There are side lobes for the rectangle window. Here, the cutoff frequency that we are planning is 2000 Hz or 2 kHz. And sampling rate that we considered is 16,000 samples per second. And the concerned equivalent digital frequency we can find with the help of this formula, right? Omega equals to 2 pi f by fs. F cutoff equals to 2000 and fs equals to 16,000. From this, you can try to find the digital cutoff frequency omega c, right? With the help of this one. This is analog frequency to digital frequency mapping. The digital frequency to concerned analog frequency mapping. This is a mapping, right? If you do something in the digital domain that will reflect for the concerned analog frequency, right? You can try to map these frequencies. Suppose if I try to attenuate this particular omega by 0.1, that will reflect to this particular frequency f in the analog domain. This particular frequency f will be attenuated by 0.1 in the analog domain after reconstruction. That will reflect, right? This is one-to-one mapping from this digital frequency to analog frequency. And you can try to see the different windows, the fit of different windows. You require narrow transition band, right? You require narrow transition band. And in the stop band, you require zero gain, ideally. In the pass band, ideally, you require gain of one. Out of these five cases, for rectangular window, we can see narrow transition band. This transition band is very narrow, right? For rectangular window, it's almost sharp at this end. But the problem with the rectangle window is we are going to have side lobes, right? You can see the gain in the stop band for some of the frequencies are bit higher as compared to other windows. You can see this. The gain is bit higher, right? It's almost zero gain. Here the gain is somewhat reasonable, right? It's a gain. It's a problem with rectangle window. But advantage is transition band is a bit narrower for the same window size. Here the window size that we can study 31 in this particular example. And here the window size is 101. 0 to 100 means 101. This is the window size for them. And with this window size, is the concerned impulse response we are going to get after applying rectangular window. Just for the representation, we consider rectangular window. We truncated from 0 to 100, right? And we already shifted in order to make it like causal system. And this is the frequency response we are going to get with a window length of 101. See, with a window length of 31, see more transition band, right? You can see. See more transition band. See with the window length of 101. Window length increase. If the window length keeps on increasing, means that will try to approach to ideal filter behavior. You can see this. This transition band is becoming narrower and narrower. If you keeps on increasing the window size. For all these windows, this transition band became narrower, right? Ideally, we are going to expect something like this filter. You see, far better compared to this filter, right? You can see this. But you need to go for so many computations that the filter length keeps on increasing. That's the only problem. But this looks better in terms of performance compared to that one, right? We have the mathematical expressions for those windows. You see Bartlett window or triangular window. You have to look into this one. The Hanning window, Hamming window, and Blackman window. it's the pressure to convert IR system into FIR system with causal nature. Earlier we have seen, right? We just saw this one. What we are doing is, we are trying to shift this. In this example, indirectly what we are doing is, if you want to have a window length of 21, right? This is length of 21, minus 10 to 10, rectangular window in this case, 21 length. What we are doing is, we are trying to shift this entire sequence, actual sequence H of N, right side by 10 samples. If you want from minus 10 to 10, what we are doing is, we are shifting this entire sequence right side by 10 samples. Then minus 10 will be shifted to 0, 0 will be shifted to 10, 10 will be shifted to 20, right? This will become like 0. Once you got that one, then we are trying to multiply with the rectangular window. Indirectly, if this is 0, if this is 20, what we are doing indirectly is, we'll try to multiply this with a rectangular window, which is equals to 1 from 0 to 21. Instead of minus 10 to 10, the new rectangle window will be from 0 to 20. 0 to 20. 0 to 20 multiplied with this particular thing. That window got multiplied with this one, where this will be 0, this will be 20. Then we are going to end up with this, right? Indirectly, that's what we are doing. We are delaying this by 10 samples. And here also we are doing the same thing. This will be shifted to 10. This will be shifted to 0. 0, this is 10, this is 20. Then we will try to multiply point by point. We are going to end up here. See, what we are doing is, we are just exchanging the delay operation. First we are delaying, after that we are multiplying them. Instead of multiplying, followed by delaying. That's what we are doing. That's it. This is an impulse response of the ideal low pass filter. This is IR system and non-causal system. In order to convert into an FIR system and causal system, what we are going to do is, we'll try to apply delay by ND samples, where ND corresponds to L minus 1 by 2. L is length of that window, right? Window size. You can see this. For example, in this particular scenario, window length corresponds to 21. Minus 10 to 10, including 0, total 21 samples are there, right? This is a window length. L equals to 21. L minus 1 by 2 means 10. We'll try to apply delay by L minus 1 by 2. It means delay by 10 samples, right side. Then this will be shifted to 0, right? That's what we are doing here. We are trying to apply delay by L minus 1 by 2 samples to this one. After that, we are trying to multiply with rectangular window. Whatever window you want. That can be rectangular, that can be Hamming window, or Bartlett window. If that is rectangular window, we will try to multiply with constant value 1 within that window, right? Otherwise, multiplication with 0 in the rest of the position. Consider a window of your choice with W of n equal to 0 for n less than 0 and n greater than or equal to L. That means that window is non-zero only in the interval 0 to L minus 1. 0 to L minus 1, where L is the length of that window. Then H of n equals to HD of n into W of n represents a causal FIR system with filter length L, where this can be non-zero only in the interval 0 to L minus 1 because of this effect, right? This is non-zero only in the interval 0 to L minus 1. And we can say H of n is 0 for n less than 0 from this, right? So we can say this is a causal system. And this is FIR system, finite impulse response system, because length is finite, right? L is finite. And as you saw, the windows mentioned in the previous slide are symmetric with respect to the center. So this multiplication also symmetric. The advantage of symmetry is, we are going to have linear phase system. The FIR system is impulse response is symmetric with respect to center. Then you can say that will try to provide linear phase in the frequency domain. Linear phase system is, that's good, right? We require linear phase systems in order to avoid delay dispersion. It's good for a linear phase system. That's a benefit of FIR systems. We are going to have linear phase by default due to this symmetry nature, right? Because you can see, this is symmetric. What are the windows we are considering? They are also symmetric with respect to center, right? If you multiply these two sequences point by point, this H of N, H ideal of N, with this one point by point, still you are going to retain that symmetry. Due to that symmetry, they'll try to provide linear phase. So we won't get delay dispersion with them, right? This is a benefit we are going to get with FIR systems, FIR filters. Let's look into implementation of FIR systems. Let X of N be the input sequence and H of N be the impulse response of the FIR filter. In the output sequence, Y of N will be simply linear convolution of X of N with H of N, right? Let us consider FIR system H of N with length L, which is also called as number of filter taps or number of filter coefficients. H of 0, H of 1, H of 2, and H of L minus 1, they are called as filter coefficients or filter taps. Without loss of generality, let's consider H of N equal to 0 for N less than 0 and N greater than or equal to L. The filter length is L, right? It means this is non-zero only in the interval 0 to L minus 1. Then Y of N is the linear convolution of X of N and H of N. It's a linear convolution operation, right? This is from 0 to L minus 1 because of this factor. Because H of K is equal to 0 for K less than 0 and K greater than or equal to L, this is equal to 0. That's why we are not going from minus infinity to plus infinity. Anyhow, that is 0, right? This part will be 0. That's why we are considering from 0 to L minus 1. And if we try to expand this one, H of 0 into X of N plus H of 1 into X of N minus 1 plus and so on, H of L minus 1 into X of N minus of L minus 1. This is the Y of N. This is a current output Y of N. This is a current input. This is a past input. This is also past input. That means current input is function of present input and past L minus 1 input samples, right? It's a linear combination of those samples. So this is practically implementable. This is a causal system. This H of 0 to H of L minus 1 corresponds to three things in our example. We can have a look into this. This will be H of 0. This will be H of L minus 1. Here L minus 1 equals to 100, L equals to 101. And in this example, H of 0 corresponds to this one, and this corresponds to H of L minus 1, where L equals to 31, right? Okay, now can you try to implement this digital audio equalizer with the help of FIR band pass filter systems? Try to implement this one. Try to apply some song as input for this particular algorithm, a particular program, and try to listen to the output song you are going to get. We want to have some special effects for our song. For example, you can try to provide some high gain. In this case, gain of 3 for some frequency bands, and gain of 1 for some frequency bands, and gain of 0.1 for some frequency bands. For example, try to split that entire 0 to 20 kHz band into subparts, like 0 to 500 Hz, one filter, 500 hedges to 1 kilo hedges under filter, 1k to 1.5 kilo hedges under filter, like that. You can have several band pass filters from 0 to 20 kilo hedges, and you will try to multiply those filtered outputs with different gains, whatever the gains you require. After that, you can try to combine all those outputs and try to listen that final combined output. This is a digital audio equalizer. Thank you.